Lee, today we're talking about products and parts being machined and made for the marine sector. Now, if you've been following our channel, you'll be able to, or you will have seen that we've done a series of episodes, or are doing a series of episodes on large part machining systems, which is a big area for the Starrag Group. But where does marine fit, Lee?
Marine could be subsurface, could be submarines, or it could be ships. Or anything that supports the marine industry, but it's typically larger parts for us.
Submarines is a fascinating one. How involved have you been in that area, and how involved can you be, and what can you say?
Well, I can't say a huge amount, because when we work with submarines, we don't generally know a huge amount about what we're producing, other than we need something this big, this size, to reach into these areas. So if you start with the propulsion system, the propellers themselves, they're a great product for our machines. So complex surface needs to be machined effectively, but very accurately. So perfect for our Droop+Rein machine. Then through into the engine systems, and then the structure of the marine product itself is very high integrity, often with difficult materials, large products, and quite accurate features to produce.
I mean, it must be quite difficult for you sometimes in this area when you can't understand or see what the final product looks like, because kind of a big part of your mantra, your guys' mantra, is taking a part from someone and giving them a solution. But here they're just coming to you saying, well, we just want the machine and then we're going to make a part from it.
It's a small part of what we do. Most of our products, we do a full turnkey and we have full exposure to the models and everything else. But yeah, for sure, there are secret components that we can't look at, in which case we just have to work on what the customer asks us for. But they know that they're going to get a product that works from us. So that's why they come.
And when you
to
look
us.
At structural parts for the marine sector, what would they look like then? Just give us a bit of a vision of that area.
Well, could be anything really, but typically prismatic parts. So we're not talking simultaneous five-axis parts that we'd maybe see in aerospace. We're looking at large structured parts, lots of face milling, lots of shoulder milling, lots of producing of bores in very accurate positions.
And have you got a lot of competition? I mean, in this large part machining area, lots of big machines. We've seen them. There's videos on our channel of us sitting on one and talking about one last year. But are there many other companies that are able to supply such big and large and diverse machinery?
There's a lot of players in the market still, but there's very few players in the large machine sector that have really embraced Industry 4 and taken Industry 4 forward. So we've got a lot of capability on digitalization. We've got a lot of capability on traceability of the process. We've got a lot of capability in the machine for making sure that the machine is production ready, and we're getting a lot of feedback from the machining process. So that's what differentiates Starrag from a lot of our competitors in this market.